Gangster Atiq Ahmed and his brother Khalid Azim were found guilty in the 2006 Umesh Pal kidnapping case by a court in Prayagraj. The sentencing, we're being told, will be announced after 2 p.m. But earlier, the Supreme Court rejected Atiq Ahmed's request for protection during his UP police custody. For the latest news coming in, let's go across to my colleague Alok Pandey, who joins us live at the moment. Alok, gangster Atiq Ahmed and his brother have been found guilty in the 2006 Umesh Pal kidnapping case.
I think it's a 2007 case, but I guess it doesn't matter. You know, it's been over a decade, and that is the amount of time that it actually takes to convict somebody as high profile as Atiq Ahmed. And the wheels were kind of set in motion, if I can use that term, after that shootout whose images you see on your screen right now, that took place in Prayagraj on the 24th of February, if I am not wrong. And that is when Atiq Ahmed's role in that shootout in Prayagraj and his political history, or his criminal history, so to say, was the focus in Uttar Pradesh politics once again. And that is why you perhaps see what has happened. You know, you see this entire sequence of events play out before a court where Atiq and his brother have been found guilty in a 2007 kidnapping case. Since there are many layers to the story, I'm going to break them down one by one so that our viewers can actually understand what is going on. So, first of all, I'd like to talk about Atiq Ahmed and who he actually is. So, Atiq Ahmed is somebody who is a big name in Uttar Pradesh politics and, of course, in crime in Uttar Pradesh. He is 62 years old. And I think the first case against him was lodged way back in 1979 when he was accused of murder. He has 100 criminal cases lodged against him. That is at least 100. I mean, there could be more. But he has at least 100 cases lodged against him, of which 50 cases, half of them are still under trial, while in at least 12 of them he's been acquitted. So this is the criminal history of somebody like Atiq Ahmed. He also has a very fledging political career. He is a multiple-term MLA, and he was also elected a member of parliament in the 2004 Lok Sabha elections from a constituency, near Prayagraj. In fact, his active political career started way back in 1989, where he won an assembly seat in Allahabad at that point as an independent candidate. So this is what the history of Atiq Ahmed is. And now I think we need to focus. In fact, I believe that we have our correspondent who's reporting from the ground, Ajay Singh, with us right now. Ajay ji, agar aap humko ye bata paye ki court mein kya hua hai aur kya abhi saza mili hai ya abhi us pe behas hogi. Lekin pehle aap hume ye bataye ki court mein kya hua aur kis tarah ka conviction hua hai.
अभी देखिए क्या है आलोक की कोर्ट में अदालत में जो है ये लोगों को पेश किया गया है और ये अभी जो सूचना आ रही है हम लोगों को अंदर से एक सूचना आ रही है कि इन्हें दोषी करार दिया गया है उसमें चार लोगों की भी बात आ रही है और देखिए इसमें जो अलग अलग तरीके का है जिस समय वारदात हुई थी उस समय शायद अक्सर जेल में थे एक वकील का भी नाम आ रहा है जो शायद 120 जी को लेकर के हो सकता है और अतीक है उसके बाद फरहान है और भी लोग हैं तो ये सारी चीजें को लेकर के हो रहा है तो अभी इसमें थोड़ा सा थोड़ा वक्त लगेगा सारी चीजें साफ होने में कि आखिर क्या सजा हो रही है और किस तरीके का हो रहा है.
हेलो जी अजय जी, अगर आप हमको ये भी जल्दी से, मैं आपको बहुत देर बजा के नहीं रखना चाहता, लेकिन अगर आप हमें ये बता दीजिए कि इस वक्त कोर्ट में क्या माहौल है, आप लोग कोर्ट के बाहर होंगे, क्या उतनी सिक्योरिटी अभी भी कोर्ट के बाहर है, क्या अतीक को अभी कोर्ट में ही रखा गया है जब तक उसकी उनकी सेंटेंसिंग नहीं हो जाती, किस तरह का माहौल है कोर्ट के बाहर?
अभी उन्हें कोर्ट में ही रखा गया है और अभी वो कोर्ट में ही रहेंगे और जब तक कि फैसला नहीं आ जाता तब तक वो कोर्ट में ही अभी अंदर रहेंगे.
ठीक है अजय जी, आप और डिटेल्स पता कर लीजिए, जैसे ही पता होगा, पता चलेंगे आप हमें बताइएगा. सो दैट वाज अवर कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट अजय सिंह, एंड आई लाइक टू जस्ट अगेन रीकैप व्हाट ही वाज एक्चुअली सेइंग. So he was telling us that, the news, because the reporters have not really been allowed to go inside the court, but there are lawyers who have told us, and the news agency ANI too, that Atiq and his brother have been convicted in this 2007 kidnapping case, and that, you know, they will be sentenced shortly after argument. So Atiq Ahmed continues to remain in that Prayagraj court. This man who you actually see on your screens right now, I must clarify that, that man in that white dress is actually Atiq's brother. So when Atiq was brought to the court, he was brought in a fashion that the media couldn't really get a glimpse of him, but his brother was brought in court and the media could get shots of his brother, who also has about 50 criminal cases against him, by the way, getting into court. Now I'd like to actually talk about the sequence of events about which case the conviction has happened under and what has caused the wheels to be set in motion where Atiq Ahmed, the gangster with about 100 criminal cases against him, has finally seen a conviction in one case. So I'd like to start with 2005. Now, in 2005, there was a BSP MLA called Raju Pal. Raju Pal was a direct opponent, so to say, political opponent of this Atiq Ahmed, the gangster. Now, Raju Pal was shot dead in Prayagraj in 2005. And the main accused in that case, which is still under trial, is this man, Atiq Ahmed, who is the gangster. Now, in that Raju Pal case, there was a key witness whose name was Umesh Pal. Now, Umesh Pal was like a prime witness in that political killing of 2005. Now, in 2007, this Umesh Pal was kidnapped. He survived, but he was kidnapped. And in that kidnapping case, again, this gangster, Atiq Ahmed, and his brother were made the main accused. The conviction today has happened in this 2007 kidnapping case. Now, a while ago, on the 24th of February 2023, which is about a month ago, this Umesh Pal, this person who was kidnapped in 2007, was killed in broad daylight in Prayagraj. And some of the visuals that we are seeing on our screens right now is CCTV footage of that murder that took place in a sensational fashion on the streets of Prayagraj. In fact, if we can try and pull out some more CCTV, you actually had these shooters, you know, carry out the shooting in broad daylight on a road. I mean, this CCTV that you are seeing is from inside a house where this Umesh Pal actually escaped to and then was killed. But, you know, these were brazen, this was a brazen killing in the middle of a road in Prayagraj. And that led then to a sequence of political events that I believe have finally seen the conviction of Atiq Ahmed in that 2007 kidnapping case.